just want it to be over. I just want it to be over.
It will never be over. No matter what you do, nothing will ever be good enough.
It will never be over. No matter what I do, nothing will ever be good enough.
It is your fault. Everything is your fault. You can't get a job. You failed your education. You cannot succeed in anything. And now you run away from your family. The only thing you have known, they will write about everything they said about you. You are good for nothing. Why do you even bother carrying on? You should just end it now.
I can't do this anymore. I want things to get better, but I don't know what else to do. I've tried everything. I should just... What the hell? I think the only thing you should do is reconsider what you're about to do. Wait. This is the part where you say I can't do this anymore, right? What the hell is going on? I know this looks weird, but I assure you, I'm here to help. Get away from me, you freak! No, don't run away! Wait, don't say that. That's making it worse. Come back! Please stop! I promise I've come to help! Where is he going?
You hit me!
And I'll hit you again if you don't tell me who you are and why you're following me.
Why are you so violent? And how did you hide behind that tree? It's not even that big.
I asked you a question.
Alright, Jesus. Ow, my nose. Ah.
That was a clean shot. Are you trained?
Yes.
What discipline?
Muay Thai.
Ah, then I'll be grateful you throw a punch and not a kick. Hey, I'll laugh. That's good.
Wait, I just punched you in the nose. Why are you joking around with me?
I told you. I'm here to help.
Right, some weird guy comes out of a big blue porta potty claiming he's here to help, and I'm just supposed to believe him?
Yeah, good luck with that, bud.
Wait! Stop following me!
I'm afraid I can't leave you alone.
Why? Because you like following people in the woods?
No. Because I know what you're here to do.
You don't know me. You have no idea why I'm here.
Of course I do. This is Aokigahara Forest, otherwise known as Suicide Forest. There's only one reason an emotionally broken young man would be in a place like this.
And you're here to watch?
I'm here to stop you from making a big mistake.
I don't believe you.
Fair enough. You don't really have a reason to trust me. But right now, I'm the only person who's willing to help you. So it won't hurt to at least hear me out.
Fine.
Fantastic. Actually, let's go back to the TARDIS first. It's creepy out here. While we're on our way back to the TARDIS, might as well fill in the dead air. I'm the Doctor.
Doctor what?
That's it.
What do you mean, that's it?
That's it. My name is the Doctor.
No last name? Just one word? Like Madonna?
Something like that, yeah.
Are you even certified in anything?
No. That's a little egotistical to call yourself doctor without earning a degree, don't you think? I thought it sounded distinguished. What's your name? It's not something dumb like Nita, is it?
No.
It's Eli Miller. That's a good name. Wait. What's wrong? Where's the TARDIS?
The TARDIS?
The police box you saw me arrive in. It's gone.
Well, it did arrive out of thin air. Maybe it disappeared.
She's not supposed to be able to do that without me. Something's very wrong.
What do we do now?
Not much we can do, really. Guess we've just gotta go look around and hope we can find her.
That doesn't guarantee we'll find it.
Nothing in life is guaranteed.
Okay. We've got nothing to lose, I guess.
Don't worry, it's probably not gonna take long. I'm sure we'll find the TARDIS soon.
Ow!
What the hell? The TARDIS?
Well, that was easy.
Are you always this lucky?
Unfortunately not. Today must be a good day. Eli,
are you ready to be amazed by an old 60s British police box?
Not just any old 60s British police box. You're gonna love this.
Eli, I present to you the empty box.
Doctor, this is just an empty 9x4 box.
It's empty. Why is it empty? There's no console. No hallways. No nothing. Everything's just disappeared. Wait.
Old girl! Old girl, are you there?
What the hell are you doing?
Shush!
This is not the TARDIS.
What do you mean it's not the TARDIS? It looks exactly like the thing you showed up in.
I can't hear her. This is not the TARDIS.
But if this isn't the TARDIS, then what is making that beeping sound?
Beeping sound?
Eli, get out! Jesus.
Sorry about your TARDIS.
That wasn't the TARDIS.
I'd know if it was.
Come on, let's get away from the Inferno. How can you tell that wasn't the real TARDIS?
The TARDIS isn't just a machine. She has her own life force.
She can think and feel. And I can communicate with her.
Can I communicate with it?
No, not unless she lets you. You don't have a bond with her like I do.
You're not sleeping with it, are you?
Leave off, you cheeky sod.
But if that was a fake TARDIS, where's the real one?
I don't know. That's what worries me.
You said you can communicate with it. Can't you just call it or something?
Not when it's too far away.
Then what do we do?
The only thing we can do. Same as before. Walk around randomly until we find it.
So the old when in doubt strategy.
Exactly.
Might as well. Wait, Doctor. I see someone.
Where?
By that tree. Through that bush.
Maybe he can help us.
Sir! Sir! Hello? Can you hear me?
Why is he not responding?
I have a bad feeling about this.
Me too.
Oh God. Doctor, I think I see rope.
I do too.
You don't think he...
I think so.
Jesus.
He's dead.
How long do you think he's been there?
I don't want to think about it.
Poor man. I'm gonna get him down.
Don't touch him. Leave him be.
You don't disturb the dead.
Why?
This is his final resting place. He's clearly been through enough for one lifetime. Let's let him rest now. He deserves at least that much. Come on. We should get going.
I want to stay here a little longer and pay my respects.
Alright, I'm gonna take a look around, but I won't go far. Don't take too long.
Look at him, Eli. The man hanging from the tree. Look at him up there. He used to be just like you. He was weak, stupid, and useless. No money to his name. No friends or family that cared for him. No discernible life skills. He had no purpose. He only made things worse for everything and everyone around him. He did not deserve to live. The man hanging from that tree has the same senses as you. And to fix it, you'll need the same solution.
I... Eli! Are you coming? Yes, I'm coming.
Have you found the TARDIS yet? Doctor? Are you ignoring me?
I'm gonna be honest. Things are not looking good. The TARDIS could be anywhere. We might have to wander around for hours until we find her. What do you think, Eli? You don't have anything to say?
Doctor?
Eli?
I can't hear anything.
Eli, can you hear me?
Doctor, I don't know what you're saying. I can't hear you.
Oh, no. Oh, dear God, no.
Doctor, can you hear the TARDIS? Listen.
The TARDIS. Eli, I can hear the TARDIS. It's over there.
What? Doctor, I can't hear you.
Oh, you can't hear me, can you? Eli, read my lips.
Read my lips.
I know where the TARDIS is. Follow me.
Follow me. Wait, how do you... Actually, never mind. Lead the way.
There it is! The TARDIS!
Doctor, why did you bring us here? That's not the real TARDIS. That's the fake TARDIS from earlier, remember?
Right. Let's get back in the TARDIS and get out of here.
Doctor, get away from there! It's on fire! Doctor! Doctor!
Eli, what are you doing back there? Come on, get in the TARDIS!
Doctor, what are you doing? Don't touch the fire!
What the? Why is it not...
Fire! I'm on fire! Doctor, you're on fire!
I can see that!
Doctor, you can hear me again!
Never mind that, I'm burning!
Quickly, stop, drop, and roll!
Jesus Christ.
Doctor, what the hell were you doing? Why did you just walk right into a blazing inferno?
I thought it was the TARDIS.
What? That doesn't make any sense! That was clearly the fake one from earlier!
Look, I... Oh, no.
Oh no, what? What's wrong?
The fire's spread. Look! Ah, crap. I can't see a way out. There isn't. We're completely surrounded.
Then what do we do?
Doctor!
Doctor! What just happened?
I'm... not sure.
Rain? Where did the rain come from?
It doesn't make any sense. It's the dry season.
Okay, now that really doesn't make any sense. Sudden out-of-season rain that starts then immediately stops?
Something very strange is happening here.
Do you think it's the TARDIS causing all of this?
What?
I mean, the TARDIS disappears, then all this weird stuff happens. That's not a coincidence.
No, it's not the TARDIS that's causing weird things to happen in this forest. It's the other way around.
You mean... there's something wrong with the forest that made the TARDIS disappear.
Exactly. That's why I came here. An entire forest where hundreds of people go in and never come back. That certainly raises my concerns. I spoke to the Nippon Foundation about doing something, but the Japanese government wasn't interested in funding anything. They care more about architectural projects than the lives of the Japanese people. So I decided to do something about it myself. I came here to investigate, and that's when I stumbled across you.
Hundreds of people go in this forest and never come back.
Doctor... this is gonna sound crazy, but I think there might be something supernatural happening in this forest.
Supernatural?
As in, this forest is haunted. Think about it. There are people in this forest who have committed suicide. They die, then their spirits haunt the forest.
I don't believe in the supernatural.
Then how do you explain it?
I don't know yet, but I intend to find out.
Wait. People disappear from this forest. A doctor appeared out of nowhere from that British police box, and then it disappears.
Doctor, you said you're here to help, but how do I know you don't have anything to do with all of this?
What? No! How would I have even done it?
Your TARDIS can teleport. It can appear and disappear from the forest. It wouldn't be hard for you to simply show up in your police box and kidnap someone and kill them. Eli, I promise you, I wouldn't do that. I said I'm here to help, and I meant it.
I don't even know you, and you expect me to just trust you?
Please, Eli, you need to trust me. I know it's hard to believe, but it's important to your life that you listen to me.
Or what? You'll kill me? You'd be doing me a favor.
Eli, think about it. What you just said contradicts me losing my TARDIS in the first place. If I wanted to kill you, then why would I get rid of my own TARDIS?
I don't know!
Eli, Doctor!
I just want to be alone right now.
I'm gonna go look for the TARDIS. I'm sure I'll find it eventually, but I'll call out to you if I don't. Promise you won't go anywhere?
Fine.
Great, I'll be right back.
You shouldn't say that.
Say what?
The last thing you said.
You mean, I'll be right back?
Yeah. It's bad luck.
I don't believe in bad luck. Only unfortunate coincidences.
Damn it. This isn't working. He's not listening to me. And it's not that I blame him. That's frustrating. I don't want to let anything bad happen to him. But now I've just left him alone. I need to find the TARDIS quick.
Can you hear the TARDIS? It's not far. Just follow the sound.
The TARDIS! And I didn't even have to say her name 3 times. That was a bad joke. Thank God no one heard that.
I know the doctor's trying to help, but he's wasting his time. There's no helping me. There's no point. My life is never gonna get any better. I have to deal with this day after day. And the only thing that's kept me going is the hope that maybe things will eventually get better. But I don't think they ever will.
No, it won't. It never will. Makes you wonder if life's even worth living.
Who said that?
The same person you saw hanging from a tree.
By the sounds of things, it's probably close by. Wait. The TARDIS. It didn't land. It just stopped. Something's wrong. Eli! Eli!
Is that the doctor?
Leave me alone.
Who? Me? Or the doctor?
Both of you. I don't want to have to deal with this anymore. I just want to be left alone.
You are always so selfish. You only ever think about yourself.
Eli! Eli!
Why isn't he answering? Damn it. I can't retrace my steps.
Doctor!
That way.
I wasn't trying to be selfish. I just can't take it anymore.
But yet, you always end up being selfish. It's the only thing you know how to do. You're not good at anything. Anything except being selfish.
He doesn't sound far.
Doctor! 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 Doctor!
Wait. Why is he repeating my name over and over again? That's not Eli, is it? That's coming from whatever's out there. But what is out there?
What indeed? What is out there? Perhaps it's a chameleon type alien mimicking Eli.
Perhaps it's a chameleon type alien mimicking Eli.
Or maybe it's a hallucinogenic alien. Trick you into seeing and hearing things that aren't there.
Or maybe it's a hallucinogenic alien tricking me into seeing and hearing things that aren't there.
Or maybe, just maybe, Eli was right. And maybe the TARDIS is behind all of this.
Or, maybe, just maybe, Eli was right. Maybe the TARDIS is behind all this. Wait, no. Of course the TARDIS isn't behind this. She's got to be close by. Old girl! Old girl! Where are you? Old girl!
The TARDIS is not here. The TARDIS cannot help you.
The TARDIS isn't here. The TARDIS can't help me.
The TARDIS.
The TARDIS.
You only care about yourself. You only ever do anything to benefit yourself.
I know I'm worthless. I know I'm good for nothing. That's why I'm out here, to stop being selfish.
Even when you're trying to not be selfish, you still act selfishly.
How? I told you. I came here to stop being selfish.
You will never stop being selfish. The only thing you ever do is act selfish. Someone's going to have to get rid of your body. Someone's going to have to clean out your belongings. Someone's going to have to tell your family what happened to you. Anything you do leaves consequences behind for other people to deal with.
That's not what I'm trying to do. None of that is what I'm trying to do. I don't want to hurt anyone. I just want to make things right.
You...
No. Stay away from me. Leave me alone.
Eli, come back! You will never escape me, Eli. You will never get away from me.
Is this real? Is this actually the TARDIS? Old girl, is that you?
Yes, Doctor. It's me.
Thank God it's you.
Where is Eli?
He's actually not far from here. I hope it's not too late.
Hey, Eli! Eli? Eli? Eli!
Where's he gone? This is not good. Eli's disappeared.
Where to?
I'm not sure.
Do you think he's run off?
That's the best case scenario. But I don't think that's what happened.
You think something has taken him?
Possibly. We need to find him.
How are you going to do that?
Me? I thought you were going to find Eli.
Why would I be the one who finds him?
Because I can't do it.
Yes, you can.
No. No, I can't. I can't help Eli.
Why not?
I'm trying, but it's just not working. I'm doing everything I can to save him, but nothing is working. I feel so useless. I'm no help to him at all.
You're wrong.
What?
You are not useless.
I'm not useless. When there's a suicidal young man out there who needs my help, I can't solve his problem, even though I promised I would, and now he's gone. And I promised I'd save him. And I've probably failed. So pray tell exactly how I'm not useless.
Look in your pocket.
Why?
Trust me.
My sonic screwdriver. What does this have to do with anything? It's just a simple tool. It's not a magic wand. It won't magically fix everything.
The sonic screwdriver is not a simple tool. A hammer can only deal with nails. A wrench can only deal with nuts and bolts. But the sonic screwdriver can do far more. The sonic screwdriver is not only capable of dealing with nails. The sonic screwdriver is not only capable of dealing with nuts and bolts. But it is capable of dealing with nails, nuts, bolts, doors, hatches, levers, switches, power grids, electrical circuits, technologies, metals, materials, and apparatuses from all across time and space. In the years before, I have seen you use the sonic screwdriver to your advantage many times, from little conveniences to saving yourself and others in life-threatening situations. But in these moments, it was not the sonic screwdriver alone that solved these problems. It was you. You and your cunning, your determination, your efforts. The sonic screwdriver did not do these things for you. You did them yourself. True, it is not a magic wand, but you do not need magic. The only thing you need is you.
So what, you expect me just to keep messing up until I get it right?
Yes.
You know that's not helpful.
I do not have any anatomy. I do not have to be. But you do.
Why do I have to be the helpful one?
Because you are always helpful.
Today I haven't been.
But you have been before. In the past, you have done so many great things for so many people. And every time, it seemed impossible for you to solve the problem. Yet, every single time you were able to solve it, irrelevant to whether you knew how or not. It doesn't matter if you do or don't know what you're doing. It's never stopped you before. You don't need to already know what to do. You'll figure it out. You always do.
All right. I'll try. Finding Eli is going to be difficult. I don't have much to go on.
You feel safe inside the TARDIS, don't you? You are mistaken. You are not safe, because the TARDIS is trying to kill you.
What was that?
Go away! Go away!
Stop running.
Where did he go?
Do you know why he is even in this forest in the first place? He is here for the same reason all the victims in this forest are. The same reason you are here now. Selfishness. Your selfishness. And if you don't believe me, then why don't you ask for yourself?
Stop it! Stop it! Please, stop!
You brought this on yourself, Eli. This is the consequences of your own actions.
I'm sorry! I'm sorry! I'm so, so sorry! I don't know what else you want me to do!
You know exactly what to do.
I don't want to.
You want the pain to end.
I want the pain to end.
You need to end it.
I need to end it.
Surely you can't be willing to go on any longer. Surely you must have lost the will to carry on.
I want this feeling to stop. But I don't want to go. But I don't know what else to do.
Then do you know you work? Make the only decision. The last decision.
I can't do it.
Yes, you can. And you will.
No. Can't.
How How can you carry on in life with all the abuse you've been through weighing on your mind?
I try to not think about it.
But yet, you can't help thinking about it. Can you?
Please, don't remind me. I don't want to remember it.
Can you hear it? The memories of your pain echoing through your mind. Those awful moments replaying in your head again and again.
Stop it! Stop it!
Do not ignore it anymore. Listen. Listen.
No, no! I don't want to remember it. Please! I don't want to remember it! I just want to forget it. I don't want to think about it anymore! No! No! Stop!
Look at the suffering you've been through. The longer you live, the more you are going to be hurt. It's a grind, isn't it? The stress and drain of life. Tragedy after tragedy. Event after event. Moment after moment. And all of it does nothing but drag you down further and further. And there's only one way to stop it. And you know what that is, don't you? Eli, there is a leftover noose from a failed suicide attempt tied to that tree. I want you to put yourself inside it.
What the hell? Jesus! It's collapsing! TARDIS is collapsing in on itself! Come on, I can stop this! Surely I can stop this! It's not working! Come on! Do something! Do something! No! No! Oh God! Please stop!
Stop what?
You're gonna kill me!
No, I'm not.
Yes, you will! If you push yourself while I'm inside, you'll kill me! Stop!
I am not pushing myself.
Wait. What?
I am not trying to kill you. Why would I kill you?
You're right. You would never kill me. And the console room has no signs of destruction. You know what? I'm starting to think that maybe, just maybe, there's something else at play. The voice I keep hearing. Initially, I thought it was my inner thoughts. But perhaps... I know you're there! Show yourself!
We can't.
Then I will make you.
You can't.
Why not?
We do not have a physical being. We are not a physical being.
Then what are you?
We are a spirit. We are the voice in your head. The words that warn you of danger. The fear in the back of your mind. The fear of the dark. The fear of heights, the fear of the unknown. We are the conscious.
How did you find me?
We didn't find you. You found us.
What do you mean, I found you?
We reside in Akigahara Forest. It is where we live.
It is where we wait. Wait for people. People like you.
What do you want from people like me?
You're lying.
Why?
We are a collective. We exist as a merger of the dead, victims of paranoia, people whose fight or flight instincts fail them. Our victims.
So you fill someone's head with false ideas of an imaginary fear, they get themselves killed, and you prosper by getting another addition to your flock.
And we're about to add another.
No, you won't.
There's a gas in the room.
Not from what I deduce.
Electricity is coursing through the floor.
Try again.
The TARDIS is on fire.
Keep talking.
Don't you understand? You are in danger.
No, you are.
You see, it's to my understanding, you are a large collection of barren souls, yes? Quiet ones at that, attributed to the fact that you don't have ears. But you retain the ability of hearing. And due to the fact that you're only audible when inside someone's subconscious, that means that you're very sensitive to a rather painful noise that I can't hear, but you can. So when I take this miscellaneous and seemingly useless device and interact with it using my sonic screwdriver like so, I do believe it creates a sound sort of something like this. And if you think that's bad, that was only a warning shot. The next one will hurt more. Take my advice. Run while you still can.
Very well.
Eli, I've got to find him. Old girl, did we get a trace on Eli's location?
Yes.
Thank God. Hold on, Eli. I'm coming. I can't do this anymore. I'm just done with everything. I don't know what to do anymore. I feel like the most worthless piece of garbage on the planet. I know I'm not perfect, but I don't think I deserve everything that's happened to me. I desperately want things to get better. I don't know how. I just don't know.
Eli, get away from that noose.
Please. Leave me.
You know I can't do that.
I'm sorry, but I can't go on. I just can't.
Yes, you can. That voice you've been hearing, I heard it too. It wasn't your thoughts. It was something called the conscious trying to convince you to end your own life.
That doesn't matter anyway.
Why not? Tell me.
There's no point.
Eli, please tell me. I want to help.
You can't help me.
Why not?
It's too late.
What's too late? Tell me, Eli. Tell me.
All my life I've been mistreated by everyone. Other kids and the teachers when I was in school. Strangers walking down the street. Every person I've ever met. And even my own family. I've been abused verbally, physically, and emotionally. I've never known true happiness. And it's all I've ever wanted. But I don't think I'll ever be truly happy.
How old are you?
19.
You're still a kid. What do you want to do in life, Eli?
I don't want to say.
Eli, please.
You won't care.
No, I will. I promise you, I will.
I want to be an astronaut.
Really?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. I'm actually an astronaut too.
Kind of. You are?
Yes.
What does space look like?
It's the most beautiful thing most people have never seen.
When I was a little boy, I always wanted to go to space. I wanted to see the planets, the stars. Growing up with abusive parents, I was trapped. But I always thought about what it would be like to be free. To travel through space, to go wherever I want, and do whatever I want. Me too.
Where's your family right now?
I don't know, and I don't care. I know that sounds harsh, but after the way they've treated me my entire life, can you blame me for wanting to get away from them?
No, I don't. So you ran away?
Yes. I was on vacation with my family. We went to this tourist spot where we heard about this place called the Djahagadekjes Forest, or however it's supposed to be pronounced. They said it was known as Suicide Forest. When we got back to our hotel room, as soon as my parents left, I took my chance. I came straight here.
Eli, I want to tell you something very important. You are not weak. You are not stupid. You are not useless. You want to know what you are, though?
What?
You're a fighter. Because you're still here. You could have taken your life any day up until this point, but you haven't. Not because you were too scared. It was because you were tough enough to keep pushing through hardship after hardship. Because you believed that if you just hung in there a little longer, that things would get better.
This is not your sign to give up. This is your sign to keep going.
What do you mean?
Come with me.
Where?
Wherever and whenever.
I don't understand.
My TARDIS. It doesn't just teleport.
What else does it do?
It's a time machine.
A time machine. It's what TARDIS stands for. T-A-R-D-I-S. Time and relative dimensions in space. It's the reason why I'm here. After I heard about the disappearances in this forest, I came here to find out what was causing them. And during my research, I found an unfortunate young man in the middle of a successful suicide attempt. When I found him, he was already tightly inside a noose on the cusp of death. And in his final moments, I promised him I'd save his life. That young man was you, Eli. I looked you in the eye and I promised I'd save you. And I'm not leaving this forest until I save your life.
Can it really travel through time?
Take a look inside and find out.
Oh my god.
Not just a simple old 60s 9x4 British police box, eh?
It's bigger on the inside than it is on the outside.
I wasn't lying when I said the TARDIS is a time machine.
So the TARDIS really can travel through time and space? It can take me whenever and wherever I want?
Just say the word.
Prove it. I want to see it. I want to see this thing travel through time.
All right. Where do you want to go first?